Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'm going to answer a commonly asked question, and that is, what flap setting do I use for takeoff? I'll look at what's the standard Airbus approaches around this, but I'll also discuss how my operator applies that in the real world. Before we jump in, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and give the video a like. When it comes to takeoff flaps, the first thing we want to consider are safety factors. It's always a safety first approach. This is how Airbus want us to work in the real world. There are a number of factors in terms of takeoff performance as pilots we have to consider, and that may in turn alter which flap setting we use for our takeoff. The considerations we'd make are, how long is the runway? Are we at high altitude, so less dense air, therefore we've got less lift? Very high temperatures, and the same, less dense air, less lift. Are there obstacles at the end of the runway which we need to consider? So we need higher climb performance. Or perhaps the runway is contaminated and you have a lot of snow and slush around on the runway, which is going to affect our stop margins on our ejected takeoff. So in that situation, we would potentially favour using a higher flap setting to increase our V1 speed, allowing more margin on a short runway with slush, for example, to eject the takeoff. The safety first logic is what we'll apply. Here at Luton, for example, where I am now, we've got a very standard sort of takeoff scenario. A reasonable length runway, no contamination, we're not at high altitude, we're 15 degrees. So this is a standard takeoff. So we tick all the safety boxes in flaps config 1 plus F. So therefore we'd then look at economical factors and the environment. A higher flap setting creates more drag. With more drag, we'll burn more fuel, which is not great for the environment as well. So as we increase our flap setting, our liftoff point on the runway will be earlier. But the penalty for that is increased fuel consumption as a result of high drag. With a lower flap setting, our takeoff roll will be longer, but we'll burn less fuel. Something else to bear in mind if we're departing with high flap settings is engine outperformance. So whilst a flap 2 setting, for example, may be preferable due to a short runway or obstacle clearance, we also want to consider how is that going to affect our climb performance if we have an engine failure. Now, it's not great to be in a high drag configuration, single engine just after takeoff. So that is something we need to consider when weighing up what those safety factors are. As pilots, we always consider worst case scenarios and plan ahead for those. So in the Fenix today, and we've got our takeoff performance calculator here, and you'll see we've got our flap config here up optimum. That's something I don't have in the real world. With my operator, when I fly the A319, A320 or A320neo, the default will be flaps config 1 plus F and a flex takeoff. So that's our starting point. If I'm flying the A321neo, the default flap config is 2. That applies to the CEO variant as well, though I don't operate the CEO variant in the real world, only the Neo. It'll be flap config 2, and the reason for that is increased tail clearance on the rotation. There's another factor there. I will summarise this information into a one pager and post that onto the channel Discord server document section. So we're in the A320 today. So our default with my operator will be flaps config 1 plus F. If the calculator said flaps config 1 plus F is not going to work today, we would increase our flaps by an increment of 1 stage and rerun the performance. And we can do that up to flaps config 3. So flaps config 3 is the maximum we can use on a takeoff. We cannot use flaps full. So in order to get the performance to work, I would increase my 1 stage of flaps until the calculator said, yep, that works. If no flap setting works using flex, we'll then apply toga thrust to the calculations and use the flap setting closer to the standard for that particular flight. So we'll then put in toga, and that may then unlock flaps config 1 plus F, which will be the most favourable option to go with. Essentially, we come back to the start using toga, and then increasing by one stage at a time until that works. So that's how we apply that with my operator in the real world. I am aware that some operators default to flaps config 2 as their starting point. There's quite a few operators I know of around Europe who will default to flaps config 2. And the reason for that is you can achieve higher flex temperatures starting with flaps config 2. And that's not always the case. And it's worth noting, and even the FCOM states this, that the optimum flap setting is often the one allowing the highest flex takeoff temperature to reduce engine wear. So some airlines see the reduced engine wear having more cost benefit over the increased fuel burn of the extra drag. Coupled into that, the lower risk of a tail strike due to the greater clearance on rotation. But that's why you see that variation out there between flaps 1 plus F and config 2 usually. Been looking at some data from Airbus and the difference between a config 1 plus F departure and config 3, for example, could be as much as 40 kilograms of fuel. So you can see where cost and environmental factors start to build up, especially if you're operating across a large fleet. Using higher flap settings are, of course, going to quite significantly increase your fuel burn. If we look at this takeoff today, for example, you can see we've got a flex temp of 66 in flaps config 1 plus F. If I increase that now to flaps config 2 and recalculated, but exactly the same flex temperature, there's no benefit on engine wear. My V1 speed is the same. So really today, the saving is going to come with a flaps config 1 plus F configuration for takeoff. There's no benefit to engines. There's no benefit to my V1 speed. Now, once I've considered all the other safety factors we need to for our departure, such as obstacles, runway contamination, temperatures and all those kind of things, flaps config 1 plus F would definitely be the way for this particular flight. So in your simulators, I would certainly apply the Airbus logic of safety first. That's what we're always taught as pilots. So think about the performance limiting factors, stop margins, and factors that you need to consider for your climb performance. Don't forget the engine out scenario. Once you can tick those boxes off, if you've got a reasonably standard departure, I would opt for the lowest flap setting on a flex takeoff. I've certainly never had issues applying that logic in the real world. However, if you want to replicate other airlines, flaps config 2, or those engine wear considerations, is certainly something you can do, and that is mentioned in the FCOM, so that also certainly works. Don't forget the A321, default flaps config 2 for tail clearance. But other than that, that's how we would consider our takeoff flap setting in the real world. As mentioned, I will post that into a bit of a summary into the Discord server, so you've got reference to that. If you have any questions at all around that particular subject, please drop them in the comments box below and I'll do my best to answer them. Also, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button to stay up to date. The latest content. I'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.